The way that that one came about was actually connected to the naked bike that is also right up there next to it. Portland had the handmade bike show here back in the, oh gosh, let me think. It was right around 2000, maybe a year or two before or after. This was when Lance Armstrong was kind of at his heyday. And he was here, and the bike that won Best of Show was a naked bike that was built up in Vancouver, and Lance bought it. The builder brought it to River City for us to pack up and ship back to Austin, and we were looking at it, and you know, all the staff wanted me to try to outbid Lance Armstrong on his bike, which was, at the same time, Richard Schwinn was there because he was out here with Waterford. And he was kind of, you know, listening to the whole conversation. And afterwards, I was thinking, well, that's not really, that's not all that respectful to Richard Schwinn. And so I asked Richard if he would build an art bike for River City as well. And Rich, I've known Richard for a long time, and he and I have played music. We used to play music together pretty frequently. He's a violin player, and a fiddle player and a violin player. And we would do, you know, jazz standards, you know, that kind of stuff. And so I asked him to do a kind of an art bike for me, but make it kind of a musical motif. So he put like a sunburst paint job and the same thing like a guitar would have, and some of the, you know, the notes to Giant Step, the first five notes to Giant Steps, the John Coltrane song, which was to me one of the most interesting chord changes in jazz music, really. That one's kind of unique because it has the 25th anniversary Shimano Dura-Ace group on it. It came in this metal suitcase with a watch and, you know, a few other things. And I held on to it for, I don't know, 10 years or so, and I didn't know what to do with it, so it was built up, put all those components on the Waterford.